Happy Friday, you guys. Welcome to the daily live workout with me, Spring. I miss you. This is going to be a full body workout. If you have dumbbells, have them close by. I don't have anything in terms of like step ups types of things in this. So don't worry about that. I also posted a link, hi Renza, on Facebook in the group and on my main page of a Spotify playlist that I've been really liking that I think will be upbeat and fun for the workout today. So pull that up, grab weights or babies if you have them. I'm gonna go get Miley settled and I'll come back in. Come on. Okay, who else is here? Hi, Nicole. So I was saying, I've got a couple of people texting me about coming. Weights, if you have them, will be great. Not necessary. No other special equipment like steps are needed. This is gonna be a full body workout today. It's a descending ladder, so we'll start at 100 and work our way down to 10. We're not gonna go back up. It's not a pyramid or a V, it's just a ladder down. So I am going to get a few more things set, make sure you have water. And then if you have two devices and you can watch me on one and have music going on the other, or maybe do it at the same time on your computer, turn on some music and let's jam out and have a little bit of fun. Got cold today. I'm wearing long sleeves. My house is freezing. So winter's back in Tulsa. Let me respond to this one text from a student. Okay, can you guys real quick let me know, I'm sure that you can hear me, or I assume that you can. I am trying to have a little music for myself playing down here on the floor, so I'm just wondering if, can you guys hear that? Because I think if you can hear it, it'll get taken down, and I don't want that to happen. So I'm hoping you can't hear Mariah in the background. Here. Excellent. Okay. Got confirmation. Can't hear the music. So that's good for me. Good for you guys. Hope that you have a playlist on. So we will get started. I'm not going to tell you ahead of time the order of the moves. We'll just kind of take them as they come. So if you end up waiting for me, reading you, okay, barely, I think barely is okay. If you end up waiting for me to finish a move, do a plank or just do something to keep you moving while you wait for me to catch up, okay? And actually, the way that the program is written today, we can just hop right into it and use these initial like 2 to 3 moves as part of the warm up. So our first move is, oh, I'm sorry, Frankie and Mama, crying babies. We're gonna start with a 100 second plank. That's 1 minute and 40 seconds. So come on down. Hey Bob, welcome, welcome. Come on down to plank position. I will keep track of the time. I'll tell you every 30 seconds. So if you want to rotate from front plank to side plank, back to front, to other side, back to front, you have enough time and you're kind of aware of the time that's passing. Or you can try to stick with front plank the whole time. So we've got 100 seconds, 1 minute, 40 seconds. I'm gonna pull up the timer, so go ahead and come on down. And we will get started. So again, I'll tell you every 30 seconds, so you can change positions if you want to. Ready, set, go. Plank. And I'll watch the time. Three, two, one. There's 30 seconds. So if you want to switch to a side plank, I'm gonna rotate each time. Side plank. Good work, guys. Make sure on this bottom side of the ribs, your hips are lifted so that your ribs aren't sagging down too much. We've got 5 seconds. Okay, rotate to the other side plank. I don't like not being able to watch you guys. Flip around this way. Good job, good job. We've got 10 seconds left on this side, 20 seconds left total. 3, 2, 1, regular plank. Three, two, one, rest. Go ahead and stand up. I forgot to mention in the little intro description that in between each move, you guys get to pick your own adventure again. You have 3 choices. You can pick 5 burpees, you can pick 25 jump squats, or you can pick 50 jump ropes to do in between these moves. So I'm gonna do 5 burpees this first round. Your choices will stay the same in between every move, but you're allowed to swap it out. So if you pick burpees to start, you don't have to do burpees every time. So I'm gonna knock out 5 burpees. No push-up. I know some of you are tired of burpees. We've been doing quite a few this week. So if you are wanting something different, that's where those 25 jump squats or 50, Lauren, 50 jump ropes come in. Okay, the next move is 90 crossbody mountain climbers. Finish your little cardio burst first and then come down for 90 crossbody climbers. So knee's gonna come across to the opposite elbow. 90 total, not 90 each. 5. There's 10. You can go slow or fast. There's 20. Halfway, 50. Whew. Arms need a break. All right, 40 to go. 3, 2, 1, I'm going. Burpees. I'm going for burpees. They may be the hardest, but there's the fewest of them. Whew. Okay. Next we've got crab walk squats. So this is where you can hold a weight. If you want to, don't have to. I will do that. So depending on how much space you have, that crab walk, you're gonna start with your feet together and step out to your squat position and then press together. So you can go back and forth in one place here, or if you've got more room, just walk across as far as you can and come back. We're doing 80 total. You guys hear Brittany? All right, here we go. So 40 each way, 80 total squats. I'll count it out every 10 again. I think that was 8. 20 for me. There's 30. Much math in my head, so I stopped counting. 64. If you want to pick 50 jump ropes and then go right into 70, That's up to you. Or you can do 25 jump squats or 5 burpees. I'm gonna do jump ropes here and just string it all together into 120. You pick what you wanna do the most. If you don't wanna jump rope, you can tap a step, your weight, something in front of you. Just alternate tapping. Every foot stepping can count as one, okay? Here we go. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. I'm trying to jump like Renza. I can't do it without a jump rope. 60, 80, don't forget after you finish your cardio blast, you've got 70 jump ropes, 90, I'm doing 120. Okay, good job. We've got another cardio blast, so if you want to add on 50 more jump ropes to that, you can. If you want to do squat jumps or squats, you've got 25. Hi, Christine. If you want to do burpees, you can do burpees. Only 5 burpees. I'm going to go for squat jumps this time. Coming up after this is toe touches on your back, so you get a little leg rest if that helps you make a decision. Legs will be straight up in the air. You're doing 60 little crunch ups to reach for your toes. You can hold a weight or not. You'll lay on your back. Feet will be straight in the air. Hands can rest behind your head for a little bit of support here, or you can reach your arms up for your toes. I'm just going to crunch here. Make sure that you, from this position here, take a deep breath in. And then exhale, pull your hips back to crunch down. Here we go. 2, 4, 6. Here's 10. We're doing 60. Done with our reps, but halfway done, we're more than halfway done with our total reps. So we're halfway done with the number of types of moves that we have to do. So we'll come back down. Those crab kicks, we're gonna start in a sitting position with your hands behind you. We're just doing 50 total, not 50 on each side. You're gonna press up and reach for the opposite foot the best that you can. Try to keep your bum off the ground the whole time. So right arm, left foot together. Then you switch. And it's like a little crunch here as you try to reach up for that toe. Okay, 50 total, that was three, we're counting it. Four. Keep it up, you guys. Press strong into those hands and the foot. Don't forget to get your legs involved. I'm moving off the screen. Where are we at? 20, 24, halfway. Got lion's mane flying all around in here. 27, it's more than 27, but I can't count. Okay, 30. 10 more, 9, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, rest. Oh, okay, what are you choosing? I'm gonna go back to jump ropes. 50. Okay, this next one's gonna be tough. It's only 40, but it's 40 on each leg. And we're gonna do single leg squats. So since if you have a chair and you wanna sit down onto it, like we do the benches, you can do that. If you don't, I don't, I'm gonna show you how to use a dumbbell to do it instead. A dumbbell or a block, or it's just something that you can set up on its end like this. So I'm gonna set that up here in front of my space. I'm gonna pick a leg to start on, and I'm gonna squat down to tap it with my hand. So try not to have it be like a single leg deadlift, bend from the hips like this. It's a squat, so your knee is bending too, and then you're pressing back up. 40 on each side. If you want to break it down into four sets of 10 and 10, that's fine. Two sets of 20 and 20, or one set of 40 and 40. It's up to you. Here we go. We're on the downslope, you guys. Two. All right, I'm gonna switch. I'm gonna do four sets of 10 on each leg. This is probably, I think, our hardest segment. But we can get through it one rep at a time, one day at a time. Does it kill you guys to not know what's coming next? Or do you like the surprise? Okay, that's 10 on that leg for me. I'm gonna switch back to my first leg for 10 more. Keep bending at the knee. Keep your chest up so it's not a single leg deadlift. Bend of the hip and the knee. One more on this side. Okay, halfway done with that leg. If you're doing bigger sets than 10, props to you. Keep it up. All right, I'm halfway through it all. If you're waiting for me, go ahead and do your next cardio blast, and then you can hold a plank till the rest of us catch you. How you guys doing? Let me know on those single leg squats when you get finished. Leave a little comment, say done. Eight. Nine. Ten. Nobody yet. All right, I'm on my last set of 10 for each leg. Keep going. One, two. You get tired. 10. Okay, last set on the last leg. Stand all the way up at the top. Knees and hips go straight. 4. Give me a thumbs up or a comment that you're done with single leg squats, and then you can go right into your 5 burpees, 25 jump squats, or 50 jump ropes. Our next move is an arm move, so we have no leg moves left. So I'm gonna go ahead and do jump squats for mine. No arm moves left. I mean, like, no leg moves, only arms and abs. All right. What do we say up here? That was tough. Good job, Nicole. Screen high five. Whew. Okay, I'll wait. Give you guys a second. After this cardio blast. All right, good disclosure, Renza. Hi, Francis. Okay, next move. At least you'll know what's coming up, Renza. You won't be in the dark like everybody else. We've got no squat, just a curl and a press. So if you've got something that you can hold on to, your weights, grab your weights, your baby, a gallon of milk, anything, just 30 times here. And here, I'm gonna use one dumbbell. If you have two, you can do one in each hand, but I don't have the good weight for me to do one in each hand. So I'm gonna do a bigger weight in between my hands, up and down. We got 30. I have the Backstreet Boys on now. Keep playing games with my heart. Here's 10. Try to hold steady through your torso, brace through your core so you're not swinging too much. 13. 14. Halfway. Start to count it down. 15. 14. 13. It's burning a little in those shoulders. 12. 10. Here's 8 or 7, I can't remember. We'll err on the side of caution. This will be 6. 4, 3, 2, last one. All right, when you get done with your 30, we just have 2 moves left. We got abs coming up next, and then we'll finish with some pushups. So pick your cardio blast. I'm gonna do jumping ropes again. Okay, 1, 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 50. All right, 2 moves left. We can do it. We got V-ups next. And since I'm a nice teacher and things are weird, if you guys want to sub out a different ab move that you love, you can sub out a different ab move. But you got to do 20 on each side if you're switching to bicycles or Russian twists or whatever. So pick your favorite core move. Do 20 on each side. I'm going to stick with V-ups. Then we'll do a cardio blast, then we'll do our push-ups, and then we'll be done. Another day down. All right.
Here we go.
Halfway through, 10 to go. Three, 6, 4 left, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, pick your cardio. We got 2 left. This cardio, push-ups, last cardio, all right? Going back to burpees. Okay, the last move is 10 total, 5 to each side. Push up with a rotation or an open up. So you're gonna do your push up. And then at the top, you're gonna open to a side plank. Come back down, do your push-up, open to the other side plank. All right, you can do these from your knees as well. You just rotate the bottom knee down and the top knee comes up when you open up. So I'll show you both. Come on down. I'll do knees first for 4, and then I'll go to toes. So if you're on your knees, you're here, push-up. Rotate onto the right side. Extend the top leg out, bottom knee is down for support. Roll back to your hands and knees, push up. Other side, that's 2, we're going to 10. 3, 4. Come up to your toes if you can. Not enough space in here. 4 to go. 4, 3, to the knees, two. Last one. Okay, stand up. Last cardio. I'm going for jump squats, really get those legs burning. You pick what you want. Doing Francis, slow exhales when you finish. Got my heart rate up for sure. Not that sweaty because the heater's off and it's cold out, but all right, come down to your favorite way to meditate after class. Yes, Nicole, high five. Done. That was a good one. I'll definitely keep the variety coming on Fridays. Mondays we'll probably stick to our typical structure. The time circuits on Mondays, the Tabatas on Wednesdays, and then full body grab bag on Fridays. Put you guys up here. Maybe. Yeah. Okay, so settle into a comfortable, relaxing position for you. If it's on your back, try a little figure four stretch here for those glutes, which will be sore from the single leg squats. And then let your breath relax you into the ground. Turn the music off now. So big, slow exhales. Feel your muscles and your skin get heavy to the earth around your bones. Good, couple more deep breaths. Fill up with that air as much as you can, and a big exhale out of the mouth. Let it go. We'll start our meditation today as we usually do with a little bit of gratitude. Hi, Annabeth, you just missed it. But we're doing meditation, so hop in. Think of 2 to 3 things that you can be grateful for today, very specific things. I'll share mine today because I did this yesterday too, but and even though it's a little bit wintry outside, I'm very grateful that it is spring right now and not the dead of winter or the dead of summer. It makes escaping the house a lot more enjoyable, and I think we would be in a much tougher spot if it was winter or summer. So I'm very grateful for that. I am grateful for Miley keeping me company. I know that all of you guys, most of you guys have your little fur babies, and they just bring so much laughter and joy to this time, comfort. And finally, I'm so grateful, and I mean this so much, to have this community here to show up for. I really appreciate you guys continuing to support me, and I appreciate you keeping this commitment to yourselves. I know that it is hard right now. Motivation is non-existent, structure is non-existent, and it's important, I think, to you to keep showing up, and I'm glad that you're doing that for yourselves, and I'm happy that I have people like you to show up for, so thank you for giving me that. Let's just close with a few more deep breaths, and if you can pick out one thing that you've been worrying about or kind of holding on to in your thoughts in the daytimes, let that go with each exhale. There's a lot out of our control right now, and things that are out of our control, it doesn't really serve us to worry about, because there's nothing we can do about it anyway, no matter what the outcome is. So find something specific that you can let go of on your breaths out while you finish up here. Stay here as long as you need, and I'll see you next time. Thank you so much.